23, behold, a virgin shall be with child, and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, meaning the God with us. Jesus Christ still empowers his followers to change the world today. Distance is not a barrier to God's move. Emmanuel TV, God with us.
God's word is his gift to mankind. When we read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, we see that Christ and his word are one. Learn to dream again as we look to God through his word by his spirit. Get ready to open your heart to God's word, faith and spirit as we listen to what God has to say in today's Standard for Life.
Life through the Spirit. When one does not worship God, who is a spirit in the spirit, the worship is defective. That is carnal. If we do not worship God, who is a spirit in the spirit, can we hope to obtain his favor and acceptance? Holy Spirit has the power of choice, but you has the ability to decide. That is, exercise the will to the mind. Tell your neighbor, commit yourself to the guidance of the word. The word is the tool in the hands of the Holy Spirit. He gives us the word. If the word does not pass through him, you are speaking to yourself, you are speaking of yourself. No one can obey the word of God. Without being led by the Holy Spirit. You must be led by the Holy Spirit to obey the word of God. If not, how will you? Because the Holy Spirit gives the word. The word is a tool in the hands of the Holy Spirit. Tool. With this, our knowledge of the scripture is not the key. Obedience is. You can master and quote the chapter and verses in the Bible for years. And hear thousands of sermons. Read many Christian books, but still wear spiritual diapers. This is a spiritual baby. Yes, still wear spiritual diapers upon your knowledge of the scriptures.
Let us continue to worship the Lord. Lift your hands and begin to worship him. What a God we have to worship, what a Son we have to praise. And what a future lies before us. Lift your hands and begin to worship him. Lord, come and fill our heart, oh God. Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsty in my soul. Yeah. my cup, tea. Fill it up, fill it up, fill it up.
Praise and adoration.
Praise and adoration.
All the praise. lift your hands, people of God. Worship, worship. Worship the miracle worker. Worship the destiny changer. Worship the victory giver. Come on, lift your hands. Come on, worship him. Your miracle today. Come and work your
I don't want to sing the latest song. I don't want to percolate the crowd. I just want to make you smile. I don't care what things I'm right or wrong. I don't care who tries to calm me down. I just wanna praise you now. 'Cause you covered me in the midst of it all. You loved me. You gave me another chance. You saw my needs when others saw my faults. You forgave me. I didn't have to listen for my name. You didn't have to walk me down the aisle. I just wanna make you proud. Should've made the heart of faith. All this seems a special seat. I just hope you'll be pleased. You covered me in the midst of it all. You loved me, gave me another chance. You rescued me. I was going to fall and fall. So in
Hey, Josh. Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you. Hallelujah. Viewers all over the world. We recognize you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Today we shall look at the practical side of Christianity. When we say practical side of Christianity, we talk of the Spirit of God Himself. That is life through the Spirit. Turn your Bible with me. We take our reading from the book of Romans 8. Therefore, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Therefore, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit, law, L-A-W, the law of the Spirit who gives life has set you free from the law of sin and death. You see, where you see sin, you see death. Because they are synonymous. Sin, S-I-N, and death, they are synonymous. I mean, the same father, the same mother, the same family. For what the law was powerless to do, because it was weakened by the flesh, God did by sending His own Son in the likeness of what? Sinful flesh. Let's now go to our proof test. I'll take this proof test from verse 14. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. It means if you are not worship God in spirit, you are not one. Because God is spirit and His worshiper do so in spirit and what? I can hear you. If you are not worshiping Him in spirit, you are not one of the children. God is spirit. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God. Think about that. You can judge yourself. You can know whom you are serving, if you are one of them. This means God is spirit. If we do not worship God, who is in the spirit, you will be led by your emotion. That is intellectually. That is what you see, what you hear, what and how you feel. If there is no money in your pocket, you say, Jesus, because. If there is money, you say, hallelujah, Jesus Christ. Many of us are here today because you have some money with you. Sometime in the past, when there were no money, you were not here. Because you are not led by the Spirit. When there's no food on the table, you say, oh, why? No church, no prayer. When there's food on the table, you say, oh, hallelujah, Emmanuel. What our circumstances look like, if it's good, when you want to pray, you say, oh, Jesus, Jesus, I'm sick, my leg is paining me. Because you know there's no time you will not have one or two things. What man wants is unlimited. So when are you going to say in your prayer, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Seeking miracle, miracle, miracle. Salvation is there. Seek first kingdom, all others. If we do not worship God, who is a spirit in the spirit, can we hope to obtain his favor and acceptance? Can we hope to obtain his what? His favor and acceptance. Can we hope? So we miss the end of worship. May we worship ourselves. This is why you say, you pray, so frustrating. Viewers all over the world, wherever you are. I know you have listened to me. My message is in your bedroom, it's in your room, wherever you are. Where can you go from this presence? If you are under the influence of my voice, listen to me. There's no difference between here and where you are. Believing is our connection. Allow the Spirit of God to lead you. Act on his guidance. Act on his word. On his guidance. Because man has ability to look. Holy Spirit looks as he wills. Man has ability to talk. Holy Spirit talks as he wills. How will you know who is talking to you, whether it's TB Joshua or Holy Spirit himself? When you are not in the spirit, you can't know. This is why our life is epileptic, up, down. We don't know the true ministers of God. You don't know. You only listen to the eloquence, power to speak, friendliness. No, these are man natural gifts. You know, the Holy Spirit has a mind. The Holy Spirit has a mind. When you read the book of Acts 16, verse 6 to 7, Holy Spirit has a mind. In that book of Romans 8, verse 27, the mind of Holy Spirit. A person has the ability to decide. No, I'm going. You have ability to decide. That is, exercise the will through the mind. To exercise the will through the mind. Holy Spirit has the power of choice. When a pastor is talking, you need to know who is talking. Don't go by the ability to present or to deliver. No. Anybody can deliver without the power of Holy Ghost. Holy Spirit has the power of choice. But you has the ability to decide. That is, exercise the will through the mind. Tell your neighbor, commit yourself to the guidance of the word. I can hear you. I can hear you. Viewers all over the world, say to your neighbor or say to yourself, commit yourself to the guidance of the word. Tell your neighbor. I can hear you. Yes, commit yourself to the guidance of the word. Because God's word refreshes our mind. And his spirit renews our strength. Where can we go from his presence? When one does not worship God, who is a spirit in the spirit, the worship is defective. Are you with me? When one does not worship God, who is a spirit in the spirit. The worship is defective. It's defective. That is carnal. Dealing only in the letter. Jesus, amen. Dealing only in the letter and referring to the spirit and the sign which are at a distance by types and ceremonies. No, I want to read. Just read what is here. Okay, Jesus is Nazareth, said this. No. Whatever we need to examine it in the light of God's word, because Holy Spirit gives us the word. That is, the word is the tool in the hands of Holy Spirit. This word is truth. Look at this is truth, Mike. This is me. If I'm not talking to this mind, Mike cannot joke. So, in the same way, the word is the tool in the hands of the Holy Spirit. He gives us the word. If the word does not pass through him, you are speaking to yourself, you are speaking of yourself. It is easier to say what God is not than to say what God is. I take it back again. It is easier to say what God is not than to say what God is. We oftentimes say, the Spirit of God said this, the Spirit of God said that. When our worship is carnal, where do you see the Spirit of God? How do you manage to hear from the Spirit of God when your worship is carnal? When we know this, when you are not called, you should be mentioned. Jesus says, it's not. I'm talking to you, church. We must depend upon God's Spirit for strength and assistance. Laying our soul under his influences and operation. We must worship him with fierceness of thought and a flame of affection. You know, with awe within you, with awe within me. My heart, my shoulder, my knees, my toes, my heart, my shoulder, my knee, my toes. My heart, my shoulder, my knees, my toes, they all belong to Jesus.
My head, my shoulder, my knees,
sit down.
My toes. My head, my shoulder, my knees, my toes. My head, my shoulder, my knees, my toes. They all belong to Jesus.
We must worship him with fierceness of thought and a flame of affection. I mean, with awe that's within us. Whenever you see me talk about Jesus, is the owner of my soul. Whenever you see me talk about Jesus,
he's the owner of my soul. He's the owner, he's the owner, he's the owner of my
is a call from the book of Romans 1, verse 9. When you start reading from verse 1 to the end, that's the message of Paul. Worship him with fierceness of thought and a flame of affection with all that is within you. Or commit yourself to the guidance of the word. No one can obey the word of God without being led by the Holy Spirit. You must be led by the Holy Spirit to obey the word of God. If not, how will you? Because the Holy Spirit gives the words. The word is a tool in the hands of the Holy Spirit. Tools. With this, our knowledge of the scripture is not the key. Obedience is. Tell your neighbor, our knowledge of the scripture is not the key. It's not the issue. Obedience is. You must read, study to live, not just read to teach or to preach, but to live. Our knowledge of the scripture is not the issue. Obedience is. You can master and quote the chapter and verses in the Bible for years. And hear thousands of sermons and read many Christian books, but still wear spiritual diapers. That is spiritual baby. Yes, still wear spiritual diapers upon your knowledge of the scriptures. The 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 7. We are always learning and never able to come to the knowledge of truth. That is, you are good in listening to sermon. They say everyone listen to me. You can leave here today and go to another crusade. From another crusade to another crusade. From another crusade to another crusade. You are good in that. We are very, very good in that. Even as we are talking now, many came from one church to this church. They attend one church and to another church. After this place, they go to another church. This is our job. We are always learning and never able to come to the knowledge of truth. We can pay tithe 4, 5, 6 churches. You are a membership of almost 4, 5, 6, 7 churches. That is our job. Many of us here, we have finished this Bible 3 to 4 times in a year. We take it as a duty to read Bible from Genesis to Revelation 3 to 4 times in a year. But yes, Jesus does not know you, because he's in spirit and his worshiper must do so in spirit. Talking to him in spirit, relate with him in spirit. We must commit ourselves to the guidance of the word. We so much believe that once you are a member of a certain church, you are a Christian, and when you die, they will bury you as a Christian. Does not mean you go to heaven. This ceremony. And the last day, Jesus will say, no. Dealing only the letter and referring to the spirit and the sign, which are at a distance by times and ceremony. I want you to think about this, because I don't want us to miss ourselves on the last day. Hey, because there is another fellowship. Do you know there is another fellowship in heaven?
Oh, there is another fellowship in heaven.
So you think the fellowship is ending? Yeah. I know
that Jesus is my Savior.
So think about that. This is just a reflection. But you know, when you point a light, so see this light. We see the reflection here. That is the earth. Where the light comes from? Heaven. Heaven. No matter how many years you spend on the earth, it's like turning back to heaven. If you spend 100 years here on earth, it's like turning back. Means home. Our knowledge of the scripture is not the key. It's not the issue. Obedience is. You find time to read the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3. You take your reading from verse 1 to end, and the proof text should be 7. God bless his word.
Won't run dry. Your prayer.